Hello friends, today we will learn different types of 3D patterns in SOLIDWORKS. Basically, here we will learn linear pattern, circular pattern, sketch driven pattern, curve driven pattern, fill pattern, variable pattern and table driven pattern. Now let's see how to use the different types of pattern in SOLIDWORKS. So let's go in SOLIDWORKS. Open a new tab, select a plane. Click on the sketch. Now first we will see how to use linear pattern. For that I am drawing a rectangular body. I'm extruding it. Now I will draw another body on this body. I'm extruding this part also. Taking thickness of 5. Now let's see how to use linear pattern. So go in the linear pattern, click on linear pattern. Now first here we have to select either feature, either face or body. So mostly we select for the feature, and sometimes it is not possible to software for selecting the feature. That time we select the body. So now go on the feature, select the feature you want to pattern. So I want to pattern this feature, I will select this. Now we have to go in direction 1. Suppose direction 1 will be my x axis. So I will select the axis or edge. Now we have to increase the number of instance, means number of pattern we want. Suppose I want 6 number of pattern, and now from here we have to increase the distance between that pattern. So I am taking the distance of 15. Now suppose we want the direction 2, then click on the direction 2 and click on the other edge. Now first increase the number of instance you want. Suppose I have 4 instances, and then increase the distance between them. Now suppose I want to reverse the direction, then click on the reverse direction. So the direction will be reversed, and direction wall also you can reverse the direction. So like this you can use linear pattern. If suppose you want to skip any instance, then click on the instance to skip and click on the pink points. Suppose I don't want this, and it will get disappear. Press OK. So like this we can create a linear pattern. Now we will see linear pattern using references. So again go in the linear pattern, select the feature. Now go in direction 1, select the edge. Now we'll select the second option, that is up to reference. So here I am selecting this face as my reference face. So it will create automatically pattern up to that reference and the distance given by us. Suppose I am making the distance of 40, then it will increase the number of pattern. And suppose I am increasing the distance, then it will reduce the number of patterns according to the spacing it is getting. Suppose I am increasing the spacing to 90. Then it will create automatically 4 patterns. So like this we can use instances using reference, and likewise you can use direction 2 also. Then again go in up to reference, and I am selecting this face as reference. Like this you can use references. Now we will see how to use circular pattern. So I am selecting a new tab. It's OK. I am drawing a circular sketch on front plane. Go on the circle. exit the sketch, click on the extrude, select the circle. I give certain amount of depth value. So I am taking 200. I will draw another sketch on this circular face. I am drawing a rectangle and I will be giving extrude cut to this rectangle. Exit the sketch, select extrude cut command, select the rectangle. Now suppose I want the cut of 50 mm, press OK. Now we want to pattern this circular, this cut in a circular pattern. So we will select circular pattern. Again we have to select the feature to pattern. So we will click on the feature and we will select the feature. You can select from here, or either you can click on the design tree and from here you can select the cut feature option. Now here it is asking for the direction, means circular direction. So we can select the circular edge and we can go with the number of instance we want. Suppose I want 6 instance on equal spacing. Like this you can use circular pattern. Yes, okay. So this was one method to use the circular pattern. Now we will see other method using axis as a reference. For this I am going in reference geometry, click the axis and use the fourth option, cylindrical or conical face, and select on the circular face. You can see there is a center axis. Now we will use this axis as reference for pattern. So again go in circular pattern, select the feature to pattern. Now go in direction 1 and select the axis for reference. In this way also you can use the circular pattern. And suppose you want to skip any instance, and click on instance to skip and click on the pink one. Suppose I don't want this and this feature and press OK. Like this you can use circular pattern. Now we will see the next type. This table driven pattern. So again I am creating a rectangular body. Click the extrude boss and give certain amount of depth. Now we will see how to use table driven pattern. For that I am creating other body. Use the extrude and give certain amount of thickness. Suppose I am giving 10. Now for using table driven pattern, basically we have to enter the value of x, y and z coordinate. For that we have to assign a coordinate system to the feature to be patterned. So go in reference geometry, save the coordinate system and assign it on any vertex point. Suppose I am assigning on this vertex point. Now it will pattern the component using this reference, that is coordinate system. Now go in the table driven pattern. First you have to select the coordinate system. So select this coordinate system. Now we have to pattern the feature. So click on the feature to copy and select the feature. Now basically you can see there is a two columns x and y. So you can use x and y coordinate to create the patterns. So click on the first and assign the x value. Suppose I am giving it as a 50 and in y I am giving 100. Now we create the second pattern and I am giving x value as 100 and y value as 120. Again I am taking x as 100 and y as 60. Like this we can use table driven pattern. You can also save that pattern if you want to save, or just click OK. So This was the use of table driven pattern. Now we'll see further sketch driven pattern.
So for this, suppose I want to feature this pattern. So I will select the sketch driven pattern, but before that we have to assign the points. So click on the face, select the sketch and assign some points where you want the pattern, and you can assign the dimension using smart dimension if you want. I'm just placing it as a some reference. Exit the sketch. Now I want to pattern this feature, so we'll go in sketch driven pattern. Now select the feature to pattern. So we want this feature to be pattern, so select this feature. Now click on the selection of the points. Now select the points. See. Like this you can use the sketch driven pattern, but this is using the centered point. Suppose you want our selected point, so click on selected point and select on the any vertex of the feature, so it will get pattern according to it. Okay, or you can use centroid if you want. Like this you can use the sketch driven pattern. Now further we'll see how to use curve driven pattern. So select any plane, click on the sketch. Suppose I'm creating a rectangular body first. Go on the extrude, give some thickness. Now we'll see how to use curve driven pattern. So for that basically I'm drawing a ellipse that will act as a curve. I'll draw circles that will be basically my features to pattern. Now I'm assigning relation between the first circle and the ellipse. Make them coincide. Now as we want the ellipse for reference, so we'll click on the ellipse and use construction geometry, so it will act as a reference. Now exit the sketch, use the extrude boards, click on the circles, go on the selected contours and select the other circles also, and I'm giving the thickness of suppose 5 mm. Now we want to pattern these features using the curve driven pattern. So for that, click on the second extrude, click on the sketch, right click and click on the show sketch. So it will basically show me the curve that is elliptical profile. So we'll now go in the curve driven pattern. Select the curve driven pattern. Select the features to pattern. Go in the feature. Select the feature and now go and select the curve direction 1. So I'm selecting the ellipse. Now you can give the number of instance you want. Suppose I want 6 instance. So this is basically getting pattern but use of transform curve and align to seat. So I will use tangent to curve, so it will get tangentially around the point. So if you want offset, so we can use offset curve and click the equal spacing on, so it will get pattern accordingly. See, and this is tangential to the elliptical profile. Suppose you want aligned with the elliptical profile, click on the align to seat option, so it will get aligned as of the original sketch we have extruded. and we want to transform that, it will get transformed on the elliptical profile. Because I want tangential and offset to the curve. So like this you can use curve driven pattern. And then you can hide the sketch. Like this you can use curve driven pattern. Now further we'll see how to use fill pattern. Now for fill pattern, I am drawing a rectangular body on this face. Select the rectangle. I am drawing the rectangle on the origin. Exit the sketch. Again give extrude. And let the thickness to be 10 mm. Click OK. Now we'll use fill pattern. So click on the fill pattern, first select the feature, and select the fill boundary. So we have to fill this face, so we'll select this face. See, now you can see it has automatically filled the face. So we can adjust using the spacing. So suppose I am decreasing the spacing to 30, the number of instance got increased. So now basically I will increase the instance spacing to 50. Okay. Like this you can increase or decrease the spacing according to the pattern you want, and you can assign the angle between the patterns. Okay. So this was the first type, that was perforation. Now we'll see the second, that is circular. So it will basically pattern in circular shape. I will make the instance 40. So now you can see basically it is getting pattern in circular shape. This is my first circle, this is my second circle, and this is my third circle. Now we'll see the third type, that is square shape. So here it will act as a square shape pattern. See, this is my first square, this will acting my second square, and this will be my third square. You can increase the number of spacing. Then go in the fill pattern, edit. Suppose I am increasing the spacing to 50. See, now it is having only one square and the second square. So like this you can use the square pattern in the fill pattern. Now we'll use the fourth option, that is polygon. So basically for this, here we have to use the number of sides of the polygon. Now here it is 10. Suppose I want pattern in hexagon shape, so I will enter 6. So it will get pattern in hexagonal shape. I will just decrease the number of spacing. See, it will take as a hexagonal shape. Suppose we want pentagon, so we'll select 5 and we'll increase the number of spacing. See, so it will create a pattern in pentagonal shape, and it will show the number of counts in all the options. Suppose I am taking the circular option. See, it is showing me the number of valid count, that is 17. Okay, so like this you can use the fill pattern.
So let's see the variable pattern in SOLIDWORKS. Select any plane. Suppose I am selecting the front plane. Click on the sketch. I will draw the rectangular body. This is the sketch. Click on the extrude. Give certain amount of extrude depth. I am giving depth of 30. Now for using variable pattern, I have to create other feature body. So I am selecting this face and click on the sketch. Make it normal too. I am again drawing the rectangular body and give dimensions to the body. Here you have to give x and y distance also. Basically you have to fully define the body. Suppose the x distance be 30 and y distance be 35. Like this, the sketch is fully defined. X is the sketch. Now we will set up our depth using extrude boss. Select the rectangle. Now I am giving a height of 20. Now double click on the feature. Now select one by one the dimensions. So I am selecting first 30. Double click on the dimension. Now I will change D1 to length. Let D1 be length. Press OK. Again double click on the 20 and I will change it as my width of rectangle. Press OK. Now third I will be selecting the height of the regular body. Good. Double click on the 20 and change it to height. Press OK. Now we'll assign the X and Y distance. So first click on the 30. Let this be the X. Now double click on 35 and let this be a Y distance. Press OK. Now we'll use variable pattern. Select variable pattern. Select the feature to pattern. So I'm selecting this feature. Now click on the create pattern table. Now basically we have to add these values one by one. So I will set the length first and the width and height. Now x distance and y distance. Now we'll add instances to pattern the body. Now you can basically change the xy distance first. So I am changing my xy distance. So let's the y distance be 50 and x distance be 60. For second, x distance be 80 and y distance be 60. And for third, we'll take the x distance to be 120 and y distance be 100. Now change the second distance to suppose 75. Now you can basically change the height also. First, for second pattern I want the height of 35. Now here I want the height of 50. In last on height of 75. You can also change the length and the width of the rectangle if you want. I will just keep it as it is. I'm just changing the height and the xy distance to pattern and just click OK and press OK. You can see the variable pattern has been created of different height and on different xy axis. So like this you can use variable pattern in SOLIDWORKS. Thank you friends for watching this video.